Ordered by the Secretary of the Navy, the rescue attempt immediately following Amelia Earhart and Fred Noonan's disappearance was one of the largest and costliest in the U.S. Navy's history. On July 2, 1937, the Itasca, a small U.S. Coast Guard cutter, was anchored at Howland Island, the Lockheed Electra's intended destination. The ship's job was to communicate via radio voice or telegraph with the aircraft and guide it to the small island. An hour after the ship lost contact with the Electra, crew efforts got underway to search the area. While the Itasca searched by sea, the U.S. Navy dispatched a PBY Catalina, an amphibious plane, from Pearl Harbor to search by air, but weather conditions forced it to return to Hawaii. The U.S. Navy then sent the battleship USS Colorado to Howland Island. The battleship carried three O-3U Corsair observation floatplanes. Seaplanes from Colorado, supported by the USS Swan, searched an area of over 25,000 square miles. On July 12th, 10 days after the last message was sent from the Electra, the USS Lexington, the fastest aircraft carrier at that time, arrived and took over the search efforts. It brought with it 63 aircraft, which continued the search over the next 6 days, covering thousands of square miles. Aircraft carrier support for the rescue mission allowed for an extended scouting area, an increase in the number of search party teams, and extended the time each team could survey a particular area. Planes could launch and land off the Lexington, permitting the search via aircraft a wider range without requiring them to return to land to refuel. The search ended on July 19th, and they were declared lost at sea. All told, rescue teams, which in total included 10 ships, approximately 4,000 service members, and over 60 aircraft, searched an area roughly the size of Texas over the course of several days, never finding any evidence of the Electra or its crew. While the original search for Earhart and Noonan was extensive, it continues today by combining new methods and technologies with some old-school ideas.
Let us know what you thought of this video down in the comments section. And if you enjoyed it, be sure to give it a like and a share. And follow STEM in 30 on Facebook and Twitter, and subscribe to the National Air and Space Museum's YouTube channel.